by the 80s, a decade when shoulder pads, mullets and power ballads were all the rage. Some of our favourite bands from the era are in the country for an 80s mania tour, and we're going to speak to a couple of the lads in a moment, but let's have a look and a listen to some of their biggest hits. Sharing what was true, I said. That's all day's love. Whoa. Give it up for cutting crews Nick Van Eede and Nick Feldman from Wang Chung. G'day.
Hi, boys.
Hey, it's an 80s week for us. We had Tony Hadley from Spandau Ballet in here yesterday, and I believe he's been lurking around after your gigs too, is that right?
You can't shake him off.
You can't. You can't get rid of him.
It's a free wine backstage, is there.
Yeah. Ah, so he's there doing the thing. Look, Nick, I should add that the 80s was also the time of a very long coat, as we saw in that clip there. 80s fashion's making a comeback. You tempted to get the long coat back out again?
Still got it.
Still got it?
I swear to God, my daughter found a box named, you know, marked Don't Open or something. Of course she did. And that coat in that video still exists.
Wow.
It's a fine coat.
We were pretty boring looking, really, and we went down the King's Road just before this video, and Kevin, my guitarist, spotted a long one, so I had to have a long one. And then eventually we got sponsored around the world. So when we were in Japan, it would be a Yamamoto long coat waiting for me.
Oh, brilliant. Yeah, so, long coat sponsorship.
The most boring band in the world became fashion leaders in long coats.
Yeah. I mean, it used to be just the coat, the long coat was just the sartorial choice of creeps, but you had to bring it into people who are not on a watch list.
We'll talk
later. You weren't expecting that, were you?
I'm not saying anything.
Nick, we'll get to you in a second, mate. Nick, I want to ask you about Died in Your Arms Tonight. It was a song written about a girlfriend at the time. Yeah. Did you explain to her at any stage? Did you talk about the song? Did you have that discussion? Was it awkward when you did?
We
spent. And what's the song specifically about?
It's specifically about dying in her arms, yes. Whatever level you want to take that on. It did happen. I did wake up in the morning and I did write down that phrase and wrote the song about a week later.
It's but a true broken heart.
As it happens, she's the mother of my daughter.
And,
but we didn't stay together, so it kind of worked out in every sense of the word. It's a true story and she's fine about it. She's absolutely fine about it.
Well, speaking of meanings of songs, Nick, we can't have you here and not ask the question. I'm sure you've been asked more than any other in your life, but what are we doing when we Wang Chung tonight?
I can't possibly tell you. It's far too rude.
Is it really? Yes. I was almost hoping it was.
Just check out the Urban Dictionary for what to Wang Chung means. There's many entries in there.
Many entries.
Most of them most definitely not broadcast.
And is that what you meant when you wrote it?
I think we didn't really... We meant whatever... You know, it's up to the listener what it means.
So where did you come across the term? Where did it come from?
There was actually Jack, my partner in Wang Chung. He was reading this book, very sort of erudite book about the German electronic composer Stockhausen. And there was a footnote in one of the pages about this thing called Wang Chung, which means like perfect pitch in Chinese music. The old Ming emperors used to employ court musicians to achieve Wang Chung. Which meant that they would be invincible in battle.
Unfortunately, a lot of teenage boys have tried to attempt to Wang Chung with disastrous results at home, but we won't go into that. What about the...
Definitely don't go into
Welcome
that.
To Australia. I'm derailing
very,
this.
Very wise not going into that.
The term Wang Chung, though, has popped up in cultural references, particularly on TV. We've got some examples of where it's been in film and television. This is...
Yo, do you want to Wang Chung tonight?
I don't know. Probably just sit home and Wang Chung, man.
Yeah. Everybody had fun. Everybody wanged. Everybody chunged.
Everybody have fun tonight. Everybody Wang Chung tonight.
Right. Do you have a favourite reference? You know, and how does it feel knowing that, you know, the name of your band and the song has had that kind of flow-on effect in popular culture?
It's incredible, actually. I never would have guessed that that would have happened, you know, 1,000 years ago when we wrote the song, you know.
Can you monetize it?
Well, we have, yeah. I mean, yeah. You know, a few bobbers come in our way, thanks to it.
Thanks to Wang Chunging around the world.
Yeah, exactly. So, and my son, actually, I think he was the kind of barometer of it when he sort of heard it on some TV shows and was like, realised that maybe Dab is a little bit cooler than he realised. You know?
Totes cool. Nick, you've just got back from Germany. It was the 30th anniversary of the fall of the Berlin Wall. Yeah. And were you? Is that why you were there? What was?
Yeah, we did a 3-week tour and two coincidences you can't really make up. So I was there last Saturday on the 30th anniversary playing. And 30 years ago, Cutting Crew were playing and we had a sold-out venue in Berlin 2 nights after the wall fell. And only 20 people turned up because they were all down at the wall smashing it to pieces. We did 6 songs, we invited everybody up onto the stage, and then we all went down the wall and joined them.
Wow.
So a lovely, you know, continuity there. But just really, I sing 4 or 5 songs on this show. Obviously, Died in Your Arms, and I've Been in Love Before, of which, you know, they're big, big songs. You really got to do it right, because these are about memories for people.
Yeah.
So we do that, and then I also sing a song called Berlin in Winter, and it's about a guy who was forced to build the wall, live through all the atrocities, and live long enough to see it fall that night. And that's probably one of the big songs of the evening, isn't it? I'm very proud of
it. I love playing that song.
Yeah. And do you like being with all these other bands? We've got quite a crew with you.
Great. Pseudo Echo, Go West.
Yeah, it's great.
Did you hang back in the day? Or
no, not really.
Together?
No.
So you're kind of meeting now.
Yeah.
That's true.
Isn't that bizarre?
Yeah.
But we've actually merged our two bands. We do. Our show is one performance, so we're both on stage together playing each other's music, which is kind of a fresh way of doing it. It's really fun.
Dire Straits and Chris Rea tried it, didn't they?
How did that go?
Well, they became Dire.
Diarrhea.
We can't tell you.
She said it. I didn't.
What could we be called then, Nick?
Yeah, we can't. See. It's just
that could
a family
get a bit rude
show
too,
again.
But
yeah,
we better not.
Oh yeah, no.
But it's pretty cool. So he plays.
I think you can get ruder than Wang Chung anyway, so any derivation of that is not going to be a problem. So you guys are performing these concerts. Are you doing any recording whilst you're here, whilst you're on stage? You take the opportunity to do anything else?
We're not, but we're both sort of, well, you're working on an album at the moment. Wang Chung has just finished an orchestral album.
Okay.
With the Prague Philharmonic of all of our hits. And
that'd be in perfect pitch.
Very good. Very good. So that was a lot of fun and an interesting experience for us.
Yeah, great.
So that's, and you're doing yours at the moment, aren't you?
Yeah, it's moving, you know, sing to an orchestra. Very, very touching. Thanks for having us.
Oh, hey, it's been amazing to have you on our couch. Thank you so much. Now, the Knicks are playing on Thursday in Coffs Harbour. Then they play in Queensland, Twin Towns, Adelaide, then back to Penrith, and then Perth. Head to abstractentertainment.net for details. Thank you so much, guys.